Hey everyone, the name is Erik Thor, and today we're talking about INFJ fictional characters. And what I want to do here is introduce you to what an INFJ fictional character looks like, because I see so many misconceptions and misunderstandings and mislabelings. I see a lot of people confusing INFPs with INFJs, also INFJs with INTJs, also INFJs with ENFJs. And even INFJs with ISFJs, and that happens a lot, actually. So here it is, an accurate list of INFJ fictional characters. And let me know if there are any fictional characters I should take a look at in the comments down below. When studying the INFJ character, you will note this brooding characteristic, this grumpy demeanor, or more contrastingly, you will note this absurd sense of humor and this sense of absurdity and goofiness emanating from the INFJ. The INFJ will appear detached from the world around them, but they will also appear narrow in their focus, narrow but general, focused on the future, focused on what will happen next. You will see the INFJ as a philosopher with strong deductive and predictive abilities, with the ability to theorize and to form general ideas about what is going to happen in the world. You will see this self-disciplined and mentally focused character that can hone in their mind, that can train their thoughts and how they think, recalibrating their mind, recalibrating their thoughts to use it to serve some kind of vision or some kind of ideal. You'll find the INFJ to be a person preoccupied with what is going to happen, how things are going to turn out, what is going to happen next. But you will also see the INFJ as this counselor, support character, a listener of the true sense of the word, a silent guide, a companion sitting by your shoulder, listening to you and supporting you no matter what. You'll find INFJs to be loyal but distant, helpful, caregiving, nurturing, but at the same time focused on maintaining this difference between you and them. You'll find the INFJ to be this kind of support character that will always pull through and will always be around, will always be there, will always pull through for you, and you'll always see them defending you and listening to you and being there. The INFJ fictional character is a counselor, a philosopher, a diplomat, and a wanderer. They are also independent, autonomous types and idealists. Now, for some honorable mentions, Lisa Simpson is an INFP character, not an INFJ. Hermione Granger is written like an INFP but played by an ENFJ. Gandalf is an INTJ character, not nearly diplomatic enough, not nearly persuasive enough to be an INFJ. And Captain America is way too much of the perfect pretty boy to be an INFJ. Finally, Superman fits better as an ENFJ than an INFJ. Now, when typing someone, be it a fictional character, be it a family member, be it a friend, be it a celebrity, what you will find is we are all subject to bias. A bias can be, for example, liking a character or disliking a character, wanting to be similar to a character, or wanting to be different from a character, wanting to believe a type is rare and therefore this person should probably not be one, having special characteristics or demanding some kind of special qualities or intelligence to qualify as a certain type, also believing the type and ability is the same and that the person has to have the skill sets of a personality type, not the personality traits themselves. The best way to rid yourself of bias is first to become aware of it, but also to develop objective methods that can show you when your bias has misled you, methods that can help you inform you when you made a faulty deduction or when you missed something. And what I want to do now is I want to recommend all of you to sign up for my personality profiler class. In this, you can start learning to create good maps of all the different types, good definitions, clear definitions of what an introvert is compared to an extrovert, clear definitions of intuitives compared to sensors, and clear abilities to read the cognitive functions and how they manifest in body language, in personality, and in how we think and how we talk. The personality profiler class will talk about bias and overcoming it, but will also show you objective methods and ways forward to test and to improve your ability to read and understand other people. Yeah, when you're finding true understanding of personality types, you will also overcome this negative bias or this positive bias, this desire to specialize a certain type or to idealize someone or to demonize someone. In this personality profiler class, you will also learn to become aware of your confidence rating, in how confident you are in asserting a person as a certain type. And in this, you will also become able to better improve your confidence, to become better at using personality psychology to understand and to relate with other people. It will be divided into three parts, and you can follow the link down below, or you can visit Patreon and subscribe for a $20 subscription to enroll at the class. And we will start. We will start the class as soon as 10 people have signed up. So feel free to recommend the course to one of your friends that you think is also good for it, and let's do it together. Anyway, that's all for today, and as I said, if you have any suggestions for other fictional characters I should take a look at, feel free to suggest them down below in the comments. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you guys tomorrow.